Hi everyone, welcome to the next session of design and drawing of reinforced concrete structures. In last class we have discussed about the design of doubly reinforced beam up to percentage of tension reinforcement for compression zone as well as for tension zone. We have calculated the area of the steel reinforcement. Next step, we are having the check for shear. After calculation of check for shear, we'll calculate the percentage of tension reinforcement within the permissible limit or not, as well as we'll calculate the permissible limit of the shear stresses based on the shear strength of the concrete, tau c and tau v also we will discuss. I forgot to calculate the check for shear. Before check for shear, we are having the minimum shear reinforcement as well as maximum shear reinforcement. That it may not be compulsory. If you want, we can also calculate that check for shear. Okay, before calculating this nominal shear stress, we'll calculate the area of minimum reinforcement as well as maximum reinforcement. Okay, the area of minimum reinforcement in compression zone as well as area of the maximum reinforcement for tension reinforcement also we will check. We will take this value from the area of the minimum reinforcement from the code book of IS 456-2000. Wait a minute. Okay, if you want to calculate the area of the steel reinforcement, the minimum area of the steel, we have calculated the area of reinforcement for compression phase as well as the tension phase we are calculated. Now we will check the what is the minimum area of the steel reinforcement in the tension zone as well as what is the maximum reinforcement for the tension zone we will calculate. I am writing here from IS 456-2000, from IS 456-2000, page number 47, page number 47, clause number 26.5.1, clause number 26.5.1.1. From this clause we have to calculate the minimum area of the steel reinforcement. From this we are having the minimum area of tension reinforcement equal to AST divided by B into D equal to, we are having the formula 0.85 divided by Fi. This is the formula for area of the minimum tension reinforcement in the bottom zone. From this AST we have to calculate that area of the steel, AST equal to 0.85 into BD divided by Fi. This is the formula for area of the minimum steel reinforcement. From this 0.85 into, where B is the width of the support, we are provided as 230 mm, and D is the effective depth of the beam. The effective depth of the beam we have considered as 600 mm, so I am substituting width of the beam as 230 mm and effective depth as 600 mm divided by Fy is the yield strength of the steel, that we are taking it as 415 Nm². Now we will calculate the area of the minimum steel reinforcement. Area of the minimum steel reinforcement, that means AST minimum equal to, if you calculate these values, you will get the minimum tension reinforcement, that is nothing but 0.85 into 230 into 600 divided by 415. Okay, I am getting this minimum area of the steel reinforcement as 282.6 mm². This is the minimum area of steel reinforcement you have to provide for the doubly reinforced beam. Next we will calculate the maximum area of the reinforcement provided for the beam. Again from clause number 26.5.1.2, the maximum area of compression shear reinforcement, it shall not exceed 0.04 of width of the beam as well as depth of the beam. Again I am writing here from clause number 26.5.1.2, the maximum area of the steel reinforcement. Here you can write instead of AST, AST minimum, area of steel reinforcement minimum equal to 282.6 mm². From this class, we are having the maximum area of compression reinforcement. Maximum area of compression reinforcement. Maximum area of compression reinforcement. We are having the maximum area of compression reinforcement as 0.04 times of width of the section, as well as total depth of the section. Again, we are taking it from the IS 456 code book, page number 47. Okay, where 0.04 into B is the width of the beam, we are considering it as 230 mm, and capital D is the total depth of the beam or gross depth of the beam. That gross depth of the beam, we are considering it as 650 mm. If you substitute these values, we will get the maximum area of the compression reinforcement, that it will be 0.04 into 230 into 650. Okay, 5980 mm² 5980 mm². This is the maximum area of the tension reinforcement or in the compression zone we are providing for the steel. The provided reinforcement for the beam, it should be within the permissible limits. The provided area of the steel we are provided for the doubly reinforced beam, it will be in the range of 2453.12 mm². Okay, this is the up to now percentage of reinforcement calculation for the doubly reinforced beam. Next step, we are having the check for shear. That is step number 6. I am writing here step number 6. Step number 6, that is check for shear. Again, this is check for shear also we are calculating from the IS 456-2000. This is from IS 456-2000, page number 72, class number 40.1. The nominal shear stress tau v equal to vu by bd, that we are calculating. Again, I am writing the class number from IS 456-2000, page number 40, page number 72, and class number 40.1. From this, you are calculating the nominal shear stress. The nominal shear stress tau v equal to nominal shear stress tau v equal to vu by b into d. Nominal shear stress tau v equal to vu by bd, where tau v equal to vu is the shear force acting on the beam due to the application of the load. That already we are calculated, that shear force acting on the beam, it will be 322.32 kN. Whereas width of the section, depth of the section, we know from this tau v equal to vu value, we have calculated as 322.32 into, where b and d are in terms of mm, hence why I am bringing this kilonewton into newtons, hence why I am substituting with newtons, that is 10^3 N. 1 kilonewton equal to 10^3 N divided by, where b is the width of the beam and small d is the effective depth of the beam. That width of the beam, we are considering it as 230 mm, and d is the effective depth. That effective depth, we are calculating it as 600 mm. From this, we are calculating the tau v value. The tau v value, if you calculate this value, we will getting this tau v value as 1.61 N/mm². 1.61 N/mm². This is the one more step for check for shear calculation. For this check for shear calculation, the provided shear reinforcement, the provided reinforcement will exceed this shear stress or not, that we have to calculate. Before calculating this design shear strength of the concrete, we have to calculate the percentage of tension reinforcement. That means the provided reinforcement is within the permissible limit or not, that we have to calculate. Here I am writing this next step, percentage of tension reinforcement. Percentage of tension reinforcement. Percentage of tension reinforcement. That percentage of tension reinforcement, again we are calculating it from the table number 19. IS 456-2000 code book. That percentage tension reinforcement, we are calculating it as PT equal to percentage of tension reinforcement PT equal to 100 AST divided by B into D, 100 AST divided by B into D, where 100 is the percentage of the reinforcement, AST is the area of the steel provided in the tension direction that we have to provide, and B is the width of the beam, as well as D is the effective depth we are provided for that particular beam. Okay, from this we are having the percentage of tension reinforcement PT equal to 100 into, where AST is the area of the steel provided, that area of the steel provided we are having 2453.2 mm square. This is we are calculated from compression reinforcement. Based on that we are calculated the AST 1, we are calculated the AST 2. Based on the total area of the steel reinforcement for the tension reinforcement, we are calculated as 2453.2 divided by, where B and D is the width and depth of the section. That width of the beam we are taking it as 230 mm, and the depth of the beam we are calculating it as 600 mm. Suppose if you calculate the percentage of tension reinforcement, that is 100 in AST divided by 230 into 600. Always you have to remember this AST value we have to take in the provided area of the steel reinforcement, that is 100 into 2453.2 divided by 23 into 600. Okay, that is 1.77%. The percentage of tension reinforcement we are getting this value as 1.77%. From this, based on this percentage of tension reinforcement, again from IS 456 2000 table number 19, we have to read out the design shear strength of the concrete. That the design shear strength of the concrete tau c, we are taking it from the tabulated value. That value now we will calculate based on this percentage of tension reinforcement. It is exceeding the tau v or not exceeding the tau v, that we have to calculate. Based on that calculated value, we have to provide the shear reinforcement. Sir,
we got to discipline.
We calculated the percentage of tension reinforcement. Now we'll read out the design shear strength of the concrete. Again from page number 73, table number 19, the design shear strength of the concrete. Now we'll calculate. Before calculating this design shear strength of the concrete, we have calculated the percentage of tension reinforcement PT equal to 1.77%. For this provision of the percentage of steel in the concrete, based on that how much concrete is getting strength, that we have to calculate for the given grade of the concrete, as well as for this provided percentage of tension reinforcement. If you observe, if you take out your IS 456 code book, and again I am repeating from IS 456 2000 page number 76 table number 19, design shear strength of the concrete tau c, by provision of this much amount of shear tension reinforcement or percentage of tension reinforcement into the concrete, how much the concrete will get strength, that we have to take it from this IS 456 code book. Otherwise I am writing here, read out design shear strength of the concrete. I am writing the formulas here, read out design shear strength of concrete. Okay, of concrete from IS 456 2000. I am writing the clause number from IS 456 2000 page number 73 and from table number 19 if you observe in table 19, we are having the table value, concrete graded values we are having, as well as 100 AHT by BD value, percentage of tension reinforcement value we are having. If you check here, for us they gave the percentage, we are calculated the percentage of tension reinforcement as 1.77. if you observe in your code book, we are having the percentage of tension reinforcement as 0.15, 0.25, 0.50, 0.75. for every 0.25 mm, they are gave the values of percentage of tension reinforcement for corresponding grade of concrete, that tau c or design shear strength of the concrete, that we have to take it from the IS456 code book. If you see here, for us we are calculated the percentage of tension reinforcement as 1.77%. that is nothing but in between the range of 1.75 to 2.0. the 100 AHT by BD value, if you observe in your code book, below the value of 100 AHT by BD, we are having the our percentage of tension reinforcement in between 1.75 to 2.0. from this we have to calculate the design shear strength of the concrete by using the interpolation. From this interpolation value, we have to calculate the design shear strength of the concrete. In left side I am writing the percentage of tension reinforcement, in right side I am writing the design shear strength of the concrete given in this table. Okay, I am writing here percentage of tension reinforcement left side as well as design shear strength of the concrete for the left side. If you observe in your code book, for 1.75, again you have to check this grade of the concrete. For our present condition, the grade of concrete we are taking for this problem as 25 newton per mm square. In some conditions they will give the grade of concrete as 20. In those conditions you should have to use M20 grade of concrete for the corresponding percentage of tension reinforcement. If you observe in your code book, for 1.75, for M25 grade, we are having this value as 0.75. okay, 1.75, we are having the 0.78, the shear strength of the concrete 1.75. for M20 grade, we are having this value as 0.778. I am writing here 1.78. from this 1.75, corresponding to the M25 grade, we are having the design shear strength of the concrete as 0.78. again we are having the, sorry, this is 1.75 value. For this 1.75, for this 1.75, we are having this value from IS456 table, 0.78. we have to calculate for 1.77. for this 1.77, we don't know the tau c value, but tau c value we have to calculate. Again from 2.0, for M25 grade, we are having the value of 0.82, that we have to calculate. That is 2.0 into, for this corresponded value we have to calculate this value given in the table of IS456 page number 73, table 19. We are having this value as 0.82. from this values we have to make this interpolation, and we have to calculate the shear strength of the concrete by using this formula. That is nothing but how we have to calculate shear strength value, means percentage of tension reinforcement in one side and design shear strength of the concrete in other side. If you check here, the corresponding value we are taking it as 2 minus the highest value, 2 minus 1.75 divided by, next we are having the 2 minus 1.77, that we have to calculate. Next we are having the again design shear strength of the concrete. The design shear strength of the concrete is equal to 0.82 minus 0.78 divided by 0.82 minus required shear strength of the concrete. That is nothing but 0.82 minus 0.78 divided by, next we are having this value as 0.82 minus tau c value. The tau c value we have to calculate. From this tau c value, how we are calculating means, by using calc I am calculating this value. That is 2 minus 1.75 divided by 2 minus 1.77. I am getting this value as 1.08. Okay, 1.08. I am getting this left side value. Next, I am calculating this value. That value is nothing but 0.82 minus 0.78. Okay, I am getting this.